In the fourth edition of this Tech Tools for Learner Success series, we stepped into Word's magic carpet as we made tables housed in Word documents. Now, in this fifth edition, we take those same techniques to apply to figures integrated into those same documents. We look into a document prepared for the Benoit County Wildland Urban Interface Wildfire Mitigation Plan of 2012. These days, most people have a smartphone with them all the time, and of course, that device has a camera. For the most part, those photographs are good to integrate into your documents. But just as we saw with the tables discussion, images need to be integrated into documents with the style sheet format so their labels can be in a list of figures, and also be referenced for the readers to know what they are looking at. While photographs serve a solid purpose to convey ideas, concepts, and meaning in your documents, sometimes a figure or chart serves this purpose better. Since you have MS Word deployed in your systems, you most likely also have MS Excel. Personally, I use Excel as an active database system for the smaller databases I work with. You know, those 500,000 cell arrays where we test out calculations to see effects. When those calculations seem right, I like to massage them into a figure where I can see them. I want to see if it looks tangible and makes sense. This is where I make the figure a stunning part of my written documents by inserting them as figures with a numbered title. We begin this journey by inserting some images into Word where the style sheet is identified, designed, and deployed. This document was prepared for Benoit County, Idaho, as their Wildland Urban Interface Wildfire Mitigation Plan. This is part of the National Fire Plan initiated in 2002. I was the project manager leading my team of specialists, Benoit County administrators, state and federal agencies, people from cities in the county, and members of the Coeur d'Alene Indian Tribe, where most of their reservation is located. This planning document was developed with my team of resource professionals working with others from around the county, each with different levels of understanding for natural resource management, wildfire mitigation efforts, federal planning regulations on how land ownership interactions can happen between private, commercial, city, county, Indian tribe, state or federal landowners. Some had their own ideas, others looked for solutions, and all came to learn how to mitigate the risks faced against wildland fire in this county. Obviously, photographs took a central role to establish a common ground between all the participants in the exercise. Planning efforts began in May 2012 with a unified plan adoption on August 31, 2012. Photographs were incorporated to document the scenes everyone from the county recognizes. Wildfire preparations are a regular consideration for everyone living in the wildland urban interface. Outreach materials were a part of the public outreach effort. This trifold flyer was made in MS Word, printed and sent to homes throughout the county. This image of the flyer was copied from the PDF flyer, created and pasted into this Word document to show the public outreach conducted. In this document, each image is created as a figure. The style sheet application is very similar to the tables style, but we select a different style sheet number for the figures. In this case, I used Heading 9 as a style sheet for all figures. You can see here how the tables reside at Heading 7 in this document. We need to take a look at how these style sheets are applied to figures. Place your cursor in the text of the figure heading. In the Home ribbon, Styles Controller, find Heading 9. Right-click and select Modify. In the applet, you can modify the font type, size, and bold setting. Find the Format button, lower left corner. Click it. Select Numbering. Numbering and Bullets box opens, but you want to click on the Define New Number format. Here, the 1, 2, 3 numbering will work for us, but you need to enter the number format input to see the number 1. You have to enter the word figure, capital F, with the space after the word, before the number. It is left justified, and the display shows the intent. This looks good, so click OK. Again, click OK on the numbering and bullets box. The Modify Styles box is still open. Keep it open. The label identifies this as a figure with consecutive numbering, but there are a couple more steps to take. The next one is to open the format control and click on the borders and shading option. This opens a new box showing a paragraph of grayish lines. The styles column is showing you different line types, and I generally select the top one. It's a single line. The width identifies the weight of this line, and I am using half point. I want this line to appear above and below the title for these figures. Click those locations on the image. Vertical lines are not generally favored, so I keep it simple with only the horizontal lines on these titles. Click OK. Down to the last one. Click on the format controller, select paragraph. On the window that opens, click the second tab. Check the Keep with Next radio button and Keep the Lines Together radio button. These are super important. You make this figure label into a Heading 9 style sheet, but not the actual figure it refers to. The figure image is a style sheet normal with no special formatting applied to it. It is this Heading 9 style sheet that is referenced because of its figure number and label. You need that to stay on the same page with your image, residing right on top of it every time. You need to make sure your label is not so long that it cramps the label and figure to compromise its appearance on the same page. You know it can happen, so you keep your eyes on that each time. Otherwise, this is looking great. Click OK on the Modified Style controller, and you are set. As we scroll through this document, some more figures are seen. Figure 29 shows a series of maps generated from our project's ArcGIS program geospatial database. This displays the county's area overlapped with a fire-prone landscapes assessment. Green is low wildfire risk, and dark red is high. As you develop these images, you will have the ability to make some large files, stacked with deep information about the landscapes you analyze. Be careful when you insert these images into your Word document. I have integrated over 240 figures into this report, and all is contained in one file. I would not be able to do it if I treated each map as a 600 dpi image with original width of 44 inches. The program would lock up almost any machine. Just too big. There is a controller to help manage the file size because of oversized images. Select one of the images, guide the mouse to the Format ribbon, Adjust Set, and click Compress Pictures. An applet opens, giving you the option to apply only to this picture, selected or not, and to delete cropped areas of pictures, selected or not. I will come back to these cropped images in a minute. You can adjust one image at a time or do them en masse. You make your selection and click OK. If you did select the image compression option, this might take the program some time to compress them all. Hey, it's OK. Give it time. We slide further into the report, page 98, to look at figure 38, showing photographs of two county roads located within moderate wildland fire risk categories. While the discussion contextualizes these images, you might decide to adjust these photographs for better presentation. The left photograph has a dry road reflecting the sun to make it look washed out. The real intent of the image is to show the forest tree ladder fuels from surface to crown. The right side image has good resolution but overshows the roadway, not the intent of showing vegetation fuels on the roadside. You can crop both images with an MS Word tool. One at a time, select the left side image, take the mouse to the Picture Tools cap, select the Format ribbon. On the right side of the ribbon, find the crop icon. When you select it, the picture corners show as black boxes and straight black lines on the midpoints of each side. Place the cropping tool on the bottom of the image black box and drag it up to the desired cut. Click off the image and it is selected. Now, do it again for the right side image. make their heights match. Hey, look at that. Looks better now. Just to loop back to the discussion we had a minute ago when we were in the compressed pictures section. This was the second box to select or not, giving you the option to remove the cropped areas from each image. When you select that option on the Adjust Size controller, the cropped areas are removed from the image on this document. It saves some space, but those areas are then lost in this document. Another place I often go to when I need a figure in my MS Word document is Excel. We could spend hours talking about this topic, but instead, right now, I want to address one very important feature of Excel figures imported into MS Word. Microsoft has maintained an Office file interactivity between its programs. You can create your Excel figure, copy it from Excel, and paste it into MS Word. When you do, the program makes a hand-holding link so that when you open the Word file, it accesses all the data in the Excel file. If your files are all on your computer and you're the only one opening them, then the handshake is okay. If you send your MS Word file for editing to an associate, then they will have a problem opening the figure because the Excel file is not on their computer. Oops! There is a way around this problem. Make that great Excel file, copy the image from Excel, but when you enter your Word file, navigate to the place where the figure belongs and use the mouse to right-click on the drop-down applet. Find the Paste Options line and select the rightmost image where it shows Picture You. When you paste the image this way, the image is a BMP or PNG image. There are no data associated with it. The image is smaller and will never fail because the other person did not have to have your Excel data file. If you want your associate to edit the Excel image directly, then send them the Excel file separately. Super simple. We take one last trip up to the table of contents area of this document. You will place your cursor on the place where you want your list of figures to appear. Navigate to the References ribbon. Go to the Table of Contents controller, select the Table of Contents button. To the bottom area of the pull-down menu, click on the Custom Table of Contents. When the Table of Contents box opens, deselect the Web Preview Hyperlinks radio button. At the lower right corner, click on Options. This opens another applet where you scroll through the TOC level list until you see the headings 1, 2, and 3. With check marks on the left, and the TOC level column with 1, 2, and 3 displayed. Delete these numbers, make them blank, and scroll down until you see heading 9 on the left. Enter the number 1 in the TOC level column on this heading 9 row. This tells the program to make the list of figures as you have defined it. Click OK for this box, then click OK again. If it asks you if you want to replace the table of contents, select No. We are making a fresh list of figures, and you will keep what you have. There it is, all 243 figures with labels and page numbers arranged just for you. Could you even imagine doing this list manually? You already have a life, and now you know how to make the most with it. We looked at this Benoit County WUI plan a lot in this video. It has 41 tables, 243 figures, 12 listed acronyms used, and made 52 citations. This 364-page effort became adopted by all jurisdictions and approved by the Federal Emergency Management Agency, FEMA, becoming their update to the county's Disaster Preparedness Program. My planning team and I respect the people who dedicated their time and energies to cooperate in this planning effort, and the federal evaluation team who approved this planning effort to qualify activities for pre-disaster mitigation planning funds. The planning document was the mechanism used to convey all analyses, evaluations, preferences, and priorities by the people of Benoit County, Idaho. The effort needed all the document mechanics tools I have shown you to make it stand firm for everyone involved. In the next video, I will walk you through the process of making equations in our Word document, and of course, how to integrate style sheets into the labels for each formula within your Word document.